Little piece right here. Now that, this shaft fits right into these grooves here, and it floats inside this hole here. So typically I will take a little bit of grease along the inside of the shaft here and a little bit on the inside here, and I'll rotate the shaft and slide it back and forth, get that grease along that moving area, and then same thing here. I'll put a little bit of grease here and a little bit of grease on this cap here. And typically I'll have a little extra on my fingers, which I will then run inside this, because it's going to touch this area of the metal here. So I want to actually get a little bit of grease on that area. I'll center this piece and then slide it inside the groove. And so now I have grease that allows that to slide back and forth, and it'll lock down in position just like that. So then we're ready to reassemble the machine and put the
hinges
back on, or the springs back on into the hinge. So this can come in, and you had these on the third position from the top.
From the top, yeah.
Yeah. So we're gonna hook these in from the side like this, and then let them hang. And then those fit into this notch that is right here at the edge, and they slip right in there. So if you get that to just hang tight for a second, hold this head into position, and then carefully bring this down on the hinge.
Yeah.
Then you can put the locking plate in the position.
Well, that's not so difficult, is
it? No. So this piece right here has a lock so that it doesn't just pop out on you. So it goes in sideways like this, and then drops down in position like that. So that slides back and forth. And then you have two holes, one front, one back here. So this is your regular operating position, and that allows you for the head to stop. While you're setting up, if you'll pick up and lock here, this is like a mousetrap safety, which allows you to actually keep the head from bring and coming up on you, so that you can stay safe, then you don't end up with a screen in your teeth.
Right.
So lock down, but you can't print like this. Oh. You must move up and into the second hole, and that puts you in position. If you notice that you get any squeaking, just put a little bit of grease right where that touches. All right. So then this right here, you have these rollers and a little bit of lubrication on both sides and right where it touches in the nut, and on this side where the bolt goes through and where it touches the metal, so that all of these are clean and move freely. It is going to be to actually lubricate or grease up these areas here and here, so that you have an easy movement up and down. And then we also have, and I'm gonna loosen this just to show you, and this one you only have to loosen a little bit as well, so that it slides back. So obviously you're off contact,
so you got a bit of drag,
slides back and forth this way. But these knobs right here also, thread touching metal, they also need to be lubricated. So I'm gonna catch them on the up position by actually putting grease on those threads there. And then as I come up, run it through, and you loosen and tighten those screws, same thing here. What happens is that now it'll spread the lubrication. Thank you.